Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. In the 2016 girls lacrosse season, the South Carroll Cavaliers went 16-1, won their first state championship. The last time they went was 1993. And Brigid Scanlon was, how old are you, Brigid?
I was three.
3 years old. Yeah. Brigid Scanlon was 3 years old when South Carroll last went to the state Final Four. Well, Miss Scanlon, a graduate of South Carroll, returned to her school to coach field hockey and lacrosse, and in her seventh season as lacrosse coach led them to their first state championship in girls lacrosse. And Brigid is our 2019 Varsity Sports Network Girls Lacrosse Co-Coach of the Year. And coach, going into the spring, I mean, what was your expectations for your young ladies?
Our expectations were pretty high. I mean, we talked about it often. You know, we wanted to be county champs again. We wanted to make it further in playoffs than we'd ever made it before. We wanted to defeat people that we didn't defeat last year. We were really building off of what we had done last year. We had talked about getting to the state championship, but I don't really know if that was ultimately one of our original goals. Original goals were to just keep going as far as we could in playoffs and kind of see what happens. And then when we really started doing it and started playing really well, you know, it was, let's get there, let's do it.
Right, right. And you guys just like one step at a time, one step at a time, you guys got it done. You know, when we was talking a week ago, coach, you was telling me, you know, you had a lot of experience back, some young kids, of course, along the way, but there was kind of a, it took a little while for the cohesion to finally fit. Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, I think that we've been working as a team the last 2 years to really build to where the point where we are. Our seniors and our juniors, a lot of them have been playing together since about first or second grade. They play club together, which is really nice. But, you know, we had some close games in the beginning of the season. We had some rough patches. We had a loss, and we had to really learn to trust each other. And after our loss, I really think things turned around for us and we really knew what we needed to work on. And after that, the girls really started trusting each other and working well together.
Yeah, and that only loss was a big loss. Maybe the best thing that happened to you guys in a way.
Yeah.
I think it was a 16-6 loss to Century.
Yep.
You guys came back and beat them. And then I think the ball started rolling. You beat Westminster, you beat Manchester Valley. These have been kind of the blue bloods in Carroll County lacrosse. Kind of talk about that.
I mean, all those teams are so well coached and they're so great. And every year we are fortunate enough to play them. And these last two seasons, we have been fortunate enough to start to beat them and be up to their level of play. And then this year, you know, we did have that 10-goal loss. And like you said, though, that really was our turning point in our season and really turned things around for us. Let us know a lot of things that we needed to work on. But the other teams that we beat this year, you know, Westminster being 3A state champions 2 years in a row, that's just really unbelievable for them. And it was just almost like allowing our girls to recognize and realize, you know, you're just as good, you can do this. And it was a mindset change, I think a lot of it was.
Yeah, talk about your senior leadership.
My seniors have been with me from either their freshman or their sophomore years. You know, I have Riley Evans and Jenna McDermott, who were captains their junior year and then captains again their senior year. And then Abby Bean has just been a standout in goals and assists for us. And then Shannon Finch and Mia McKenzie are just always doing the little things, kind of like unsung heroes for us. And all of them have just really worked well together. They're really good, positive role models for not only the juniors that they've been playing with for a long time, but, you know, there's a lot of middle school kids that came to our games this year and watched them play. And our freshmen and our sophomores really looking up to a really good class of girls.
Yeah, and also, this doesn't happen. You can't be coach of the year without great lieutenants and generals and majors, whatever you want to call it. Yeah. Talk about your coaching staff who helped you bring this together.
My coaching staff is awesome. I have my JV coach who has been on the sidelines with me since day one, and we just we work really well together. She keeps me so organized. Mm-hmm. And then this year I was fortunate enough to grab Danielle, who is also an alumni of South Carroll. She was on that team in 1993, so she came back for the year. Yeah, and she coaches with me in the off season, and I've just been really fortunate to get to know her. And then my other coach was actually my coach in high school. I recruited him, almost forced him to come back with us. He wasn't doing anything. He's been a coach for 40 years, and he really brought a really good lacrosse library to the girls this year, some things that I never would have been able to teach them, and I was able to learn from him, and we just worked really well together as a staff.
And give me those names?
Bill Smith and mm-hmm. Danielle Preetz and Bryn Gibson.
Right, right.
All three of them.
You're a graduate of South Carroll.
Yes.
You know, it's a tight-knit community. Tell me what this means to you. This had to be just like the most awesomest thing you've experienced as a coach? Of course, this is your first coaching, but you know, you've been South Carroll, you went to Mount St. Mary's, right?
Yes.
But I mean, just to come back to your alma mater and do something that hasn't been done, it's got to be just an unbelievable feeling.
It is unbelievable, and the community has really been behind us. You know, I coach at the, I mean, I teach at the elementary school, and the teachers and the staff and the parents in there, they're just always reaching out, sending emails. You know, they made posters for the team for good luck, and the alumni have just been emailing and texting and all kinds of, anyone really who's played at South Carroll, I mean, have been packing our stands all season long, and it's just really awesome.
Right, in her seventh season, Brigid Scanlon led the South Carroll Cavaliers to the Class 2A state championship, the first in program history. She has a career record of 56-45. The seventh, I guess it's lucky number seven for you, Coach, as Brigid Scanlon is our 2019 Varsity Sports Network Girls Lacrosse Co-Coach of the Year. Congratulations, Brigid.
Thank you so much.
For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.